An elliptical basin found using LiDAR images near the Oxley Nature Center in Tulsa, Oklahoma, by Eric Brown, has led to a surprising archaeological discovery. The lines carved on the west side of the Tulsa Basin are aligned with the sunrise during the solstices and the equinoxes. The Tulsa Basin is probably the best ancient solar observatory in the United States. Welcome to another edition of the Carolina Bay of the Day, where we study the secondary impacts made by the glacierized boulders that were ejected by an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet. There is a link to the LiDAR visualization tool for Google Earth by Michael Davias in the description of the video. Today, we will discuss how the Tulsa Basin Solar Observatory worked. Previous presentations have proposed that the Tulsa Basin has the same origin as the Carolina Bays because 1. It has an elliptical geometry characteristic of inclined conical cavities, 2. It has raised rims typical of impact cratering, and 3. Its major axis is oriented toward the Great Lakes. These three features are consistent with the glacier ice impact hypothesis published in 2017. Pay close attention to the lines forming a V on the west side of this basin. We start by noting that the Tulsa Basin is perfectly elliptical. This is typical of well-preserved Carolina Bays. A well-formed berm, approximately 15 meters wide, surrounds the elliptical basin. This berm could only have been sculpted by humans. Typical Carolina Bays have a broader rim at the distal end of the ellipse created by the forward momentum of the projectile, but it is not regular like the Tulsa Basin. Parallel lines approximately 11 meters apart are carved on the ground to the west of the Tulsa Basin and converge at a 60-degree angle. When I saw this pattern, I immediately thought of the Serpent Mound in Ohio, which is oriented toward the setting sun on the summer solstice. This occurs on the 21st day of June when the sun reaches its northernmost point on the horizon, and it is the longest day of the year. It is immediately evident that the point of the converging lines is not aligned with the major axis of the basin. I used the solar calculator of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration to find the azimuth of sunrise for the Tulsa Basin on June 21st. I found that a line bisecting the angle carved on the ground was aligned with the summer solstice on June 21st at sunrise, 6:08 a.m., with an azimuth of 59.97 degrees. The lines carved on the ground in an east-west direction are aligned with the vernal equinox on March 21st at sunrise, 7:26 a.m., with an azimuth of 89.03 degrees. These same lines in an east-west direction are aligned with the autumnal equinox on September 22nd at sunrise, 7:12 a.m., with an azimuth of 89.2 degrees. Three of the Earth's seasonal changes are accounted for. The NOAA solar calculator shows that the sunrise during the winter solstice has a heading of 119 degrees. However, the LiDAR image does not show any lines carved in the ground in that direction. I consider that the lines expected for the winter solstice with a heading of 119 degrees could have been obliterated by the work that the Civilian Conservation Corps did in the 1930s or by other types of erosion. However, the reason for the lines aligned to the northeast with a heading of 29 degrees becomes evident when we consider the heading of the sunrise during the winter solstice. The lines oriented in a northeast direction have a heading of 29 degrees, which is at a right angle with the heading for the winter solstice. The clever people who constructed this solar observatory must have used an instrument like a carpenter's square aligned with the carved northeast lines to get the heading for the winter solstice. The lines carved on the ground to the west of the Tulsa Basin are evidence that this site was used as a solar observatory to track the seasons. Knowing the cycle of the seasons has always been very important for planning the right time for planting crops and for hunting animals during their yearly migrations. There are many examples of solar observatories in America. Some are spiral carvings on rocks, and others are circular arrangements of rocks, like the Medicine Wheel in Bighorn National Forest, Wyoming, which has a diameter of 23 meters. The Tulsa Basin Solar Observatory measures 381 meters from the vertex of the lines to the northeast rim of the ellipse. The ellipse is bigger than the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, California. Without doubt, the Tulsa Basin is one of the best examples of solar observatories in North America. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. I will continue to examine the Carolina Bays one bay at a time. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays.